Imagine I want to know the average income in my city, so I decide to stand in front of the Gucci store and ask everyone that enters how much they make. What's wrong with that strategy? Well, I'll probably end up concluding that the average income in my town is much higher than it actually is. This is an example of something called selection bias. Selection bias occurs when the participants that have been recruited for a study don't reflect the group of users we're trying to study. Oftentimes, participant selection is biased because it is not sufficiently random, or because researchers made mistakes in how they recruited that sample. A common way that we find participants for usability studies is through participant panels via online testing platforms. These approaches are great, but let's think about the distribution of people that sign up for studies with these services. At a minimum, participants from these sources have free time, and they've determined that the compensation from these platforms for their labor is worthwhile. Additionally, people on these platforms likely have participated in studies before. This means there's something a little special or different about the participants you might find when you recruit through that method. It doesn't mean you can't use panels, but you just have to be aware of the risk. Easy sources for recruiting can be a source of very potential bias. For example, I might think about recruiting research participants by posting to my LinkedIn followers. Or I might use my company directory and recruit my coworkers for a study. It might be easy, but I doubt my LinkedIn followers are representative of my users. And recruiting my coworkers violates one of our key tenets here at NNG. You are not the user. Okay, so what's the big deal if you don't account for bias in your participants? If you implement design changes from a biased study, you may not get the outcome from that design that you expected because you didn't accurately measure your objective. As a result, you will have potentially wasted time and money. All recruitment methods include some amount of selection bias. It's just important to understand and construct those biases to minimize interference with your study's goal. Studies should recruit participants with specific goals in mind. Should the participants be representative of the user base as a whole? Do you want to see how elderly users interact with your product? Maybe you want your product to be easy to use for a new segment of high-income participants. It's impossible to completely avoid selection bias, but it's important to be aware of potential sources, especially when you're deciding how to recruit your participants and when you're drawing conclusions from your data.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.